Bendição. Father, we are in awe of how good and how wonderful you are, of how great and how mighty your power is. And we thank you, Lord, for a year full of challenges, full of obstacles, full of trials. We had our losses, we had our gains. But everything, Lord, is because of you, is for you, Lord. We thank you, Lord, for just holding us, Lord, for that year, embracing us as we go through this journey. It may be hard. Some days are painful. We had our shares of anxieties, depressions. But Father, time and time again, you have showed us that you love us, that you will never forget us, that even though we are in the midst of darkness, you are the light, Father. And we continue to hope, Lord, for this year, for 2021, Lord. And we are excited for things to come. And we know that greater things, Lord, greater things are to come this year. And we thank you, Father. We love you. We honor you. And we praise you. Maraming, maraming salamat, aming Panginoon. Mahal na mahal ka namin. Pinupurihan. At minamahal ka namin at dinadakila ka namin, aming Panginoon. Salamat sa iyo. Lahat ng ito ay tinataas namin sa iyong matamis na pangalang Jesus. Amen. Kung aking mamasdan ang kalawakan, kung maunawaan ay dahilan bakit ako'y hindi mo tinalagaan. Di ko kayang isipin, hindi ko kayang sugatin ang pag-ibig mo, Jesus, na iyong binigay sa akin. Aking sandigan, di mo ko pababayaan. Di ko kayang isipin, hindi ko kayang sugatin ang pag-ibig mo, Jesus, na iyong binigay sa akin. Salamat! Salamat, salamat, O Jesus, sa pag-ibig mo. Sa akin ang katulad mo. Salamat, salamat, O Jesus, sa pag-ibig mo. Ako'y magsasaya sa piling mo. Buhay ko na! Buhay ko na ang purihin ka. Buhay ko na sa iyo'y sumamba. Wala nang iba na naisin pa. Ipasalamatan ka. Buhay ko na! Buhay ko na ang purihin ka. Buhay ko na ang sa iyo'y sumamba. Wala nang iba na naisin pa. Ipasalamatan ka. Buhay ko na ang purihin ka. Buhay ko na ang sa iyo'y
sumamba. Wala nang ibang nanaisin pa kung pasalamatan ka. Magsasaya sa piling mo. Ako'y magsasaya sa piling mo. Ako'y magsasaya sa piling mo. Oh,
have made, Lord. And we will rejoice and we will be glad in it. And our lungs, our strength, our voices, our breath is to praise you and to worship you, Father. May every word that would come out of our mouths be glorifying and honoring to you, Lord. We praise you and we honor you, Father. And we continue to sing of your greatness.
And great are you, Lord.
are you. Mighty are you. We praise you and we honor you. And we trust you, Father, that even though we are in open waters, Father, you are there with us in every wave, in every obstacles, in every challenges, Lord. May we be filled with your Spirit. May we honor you, Lord, not only today, but all throughout our lives. You are the Lord who gave us breath. You are the Lord who gave us life. And we will return it back to you, Father. Our hearts, our minds, our strength is for you, to worship you and to honor you. All the glory belongs to your name, Jesus Christ. Amen and amen. Amen. You may all sit down.
Good morning, church. Good morning, Impact Church. Are you blessed? Are you blessed? Today is the first Sunday of the year 2021. And we are blessed. You know why? Because God is with us. Amen? And we expect greater things from the Lord for our church. And of course, para sa atin din personally. No? Excited ba kayo? No? Na mag-journey again for another year with the Lord. Amen? Talaga napakabuti ng ating Panginoon. And gusto nating umpisahan, batiin natin yung mga kasama natin ngayon sa Facebook Live na nag-comment sa ating comment section. Si Chelsea, si Jeff from Bacol, si Audrey, si Elisa, si Ate Rowena Galit, si Christina Manuel, si Kuya Rainier Herradura, si Art Berseta, si Clifford, si Ate Evelyn, ang Palisok family, si Juan Paulo Santos, si Grace Laguna, wala po siya sa Laguna, pero ang Laguna ang apelyido niya. Si Grace, hi Grace. Si JM Ramos, si Stephanie Liao, si Tatay Danilo, si Ate Liza Yushang, si Ate Weng Santiago, at si Nanay Jovi, si Michaela or Rochelle, at si Sir Francis. Gusto natin batiin din si Kuya Rolly na nanonood sa atin ngayon live. And of course, si Kuya Kenneth Turara. Si Kuya Kenneth, nakasama natin yan sa couples, no? Na tayo sa Impact Retreat for Couples. Thank you so much for being with us and for commenting also at in comment section. Good morning, everybody. Let's continue to worship the Lord. Ang ating announcements for today is that, nako, marami pala mag-birthday. Okay, bukas, January 4, birthday ni Tita Elvi Saor. Tita Elvi, kasama natin siya last Sunday. No, Tita Elvi, nako, happy, happy birthday sa'yo. Blueberry cheesecake. Napakasarap nung binake ni Tita Elvi na blueberry cheesecake. January 6 naman, gusto natin batiin si Rodel Tinagan. Okay, happy birthday. At sa January 8, nako, ito. Ang pinakamaganda sa aking mga mata. Yeah. Rhyming, ha? Ang aking magandang misis, si Becca Cruz, birthday sa January 8. Happy birthday. Okay. At gusto rin nating batiin ng happy, happy wedding anniversary si Tatay Danilo at si Nanay. Let's share the gospel to other people. No? It's an opportunity for another year to share the love of Jesus to others. Gusto rin nating i-announce na next Sunday po ay magre-resume na ang Sunday School for Kids. Kaya abangan po ninyo, mga kids, alam ko, excited na kayong bumalik sa inyong Sunday School. Watch out! Sunday School is back on January 10. At gusto rin nating i-call, no, ang lahat ng members ng Impact Church for our Impact Church Prayer and Fasting Week. Yan po ay mangyayari sa January 18 to 23, 2021, from Monday through Saturday, 6 p.m. via Facebook live. At wag na wag nyo i-miss kasi napakaganda. Bagong-bago, in-invite natin yung ating mga speakers. Most of them are the women of the church, empowered to share the gospel. Mga first time yung iba dito, pero natutuwa kami, no? Kasi talagang ini-empower ni God yung mga mag-preach, mag-share ng word ni God sa ating week, 1 week of prayer and fasting. Kaya huwag nyo po imi-miss every 6 o'clock, i-alarm nyo na po sa January 18 to 23, may prayer and fasting tayo. Siyempre, gusto rin natin i-rally ang bawat isa, ano ba yung ifa-fast natin? Yan. Pwede tayo mag-fast ng food, o ng social media, or ng social gatherings, no? Marami, no? Maraming ways. And that is for the purpose so that we can spend more time meditating and praying to the Lord. Tama? So we can focus, ano ba yung goal natin sa ating spiritual direction pagdating sa ating relationship with God? Amen? Okay. So, at this point, we will give to the Lord yung ating tithes and offering. But let me first read yung Proverbs 3, 9 to 10. It says here, honor the Lord with your wealth and with your first fruits of all your produce. Then your barns will be filled with plenty and your vats will be bursting with wine. Last year, I personally took the challenge of giving the Lord my first fruit. At hindi ako binigo ng Panginoon. Sabi ko sa Panginoon, sige Lord, bibigay ko yung isang buong buwan ko sa iyo. Hindi ko alam kung ano mangyari, but I know this is for you. Nagulat ako nung binabalikan ko yung aking planner last year. Nag-provide ang Panginoon. Parang hindi ko naramdaman that the Lord provided. And I was able to trust Him in faith to give my first fruits sa Kanya. Let us all pray as we give to the Lord. Lord, thank you so much for this day. Every portion of this worship, Lord, is something that breaks our heart because it's something that you call us in obedience to. Kaya salamat, Panginoon, that we continue to feel your mighty presence among us and your presence sa buhay namin every step of the way. This year, Lord, alam ko marami sa amin, we want to hit our goal, our desires for this year. All the more, it is really prioritizing our relationship with you. May you bless us, and may you bless us. We learn all the more how to give and to give what is yours. Bless us, Lord, and we know that you are faithful. So that's why we praise you and honor you. In Jesus' name, amen. Let us give unto the Lord.
Happy New Year, everyone. Energy, Happy New Year po. We begin another season in our life. That's why I called I entitle this sermon, Every Season. Kamusta po ang inyong mga daliri? Dapat po walang nawala kasi po walang paputok ngayong mga panahon na to. Tama po ba? Last year, mga 15 minutes pa yung ingay eh. This year, parang yung mga taga 15 di lang po yung nakakita ng fireworks eh. Buti nilang binidyo nila, nakita natin. Di ba? Anyway, Happy New Year everyone. And as I was praying for this sermon, naka-free po kasi yung ating sermon series. We'll start the series again this February. And we're excited because for the first, meron tayong uling isa pang bagong lady preacher that would come out from and would preach during that time. So, kung sino siya, antayin nyo na lang po. Si Tatay Jun po ang bahalang magsabi kung paano po at anong passage. February po yan, yung family month natin as Impact Church. Right? Ang sarap pala dito, no? Nare-relax ka masyado. Pag ganito yung pulpito, nagbago po kami ng posisyon kasi we want the light na hindi patay sindi. So hopefully, hindi po siya magpapatay sindi dyan dahil nandito po ako ngayon sa gitna. Well, I was praying about the passage that he will give us today. And I was to a point of frustration already. Kasi, andam ko na naisip dyan, when was last Sunday? 27? December 27, no? 27 pa lang po nagpipray na ako. Sabi ko, Lord, ano yung gusto mong sabihin sa yung mga tao at the start of the year? I was reminded by, frustrated na frustrated ako. Sabi ko, Lord, December 31 na po, wala pa rin po. Ang hirap pa naman mag-prepare kasi puyat ka and all of that. But suddenly, I was scrolling the Bible, I was scrolling the Word, I came into this passage. And I firmly believe this is the Lord's message for all of us this year. I also am reminded by one preacher, co-preacher ko na kaibigan ko po si Kuya Eric, nag-post siya na wag daw masyadong, as preachers, hindi kami dapat masyadong ma-pressure kung anong sasabihin namin the first year. Diba? The first Sunday of the year, I mean. Because it's not accumulation o nung pagkakamali namin last year, but it's a new beginning, a new season where we can dig in to the Word of God once more. So before we dig into it, let's pray. Father, we are grateful for your Word. We are thankful that in our country we celebrate the Bible month and that the truths of the Bible still resound in our lives as a nation. Lord, will you continue, Lord, to bless our nation, bless our president, give him wisdom. Lord, marami na kaming ring reklamo sa kanila, pero you have placed them there and we know, Lord, that you are in control. Father, we ask that in your name, will you continue to protect the Philippines from the coronavirus, even the new strain. Lord, we know that sinasabi nila, we cannot be protected, but we have a God who can protect us. So Father, I pray in the name of Jesus Christ, will you cover us with your precious blood? Will you cover your people with your precious blood? That you will protect us from COVID as you have been protecting us, Lord. You will continue to protect us, Father, as we experience this new strain. Continue, Father, to be with us as we walk outside our homes and work and even do things. We pray for the pastoral staff and the team, Lord, who's continually doing their work outside. We pray that you bless us and protect us and even protect our families. Lord, we thank you for another year. We thank you for na pagtagumpayan po namin yung 2020. Maraming salamat dahil buhay pa kami, humihinga that every breath as we have sung, we would say, glory to your name and great are you, Lord. Father, as we open your word, may your blessings be upon us. May your spirit move in our midst and work, Lord, in our hearts. We thank you. We glorify your name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Fears. Every season, we have that. Right? Alam niyo po, itong mensahe na to has to, the Lord in His humor tested me yesterday. Nandun po kami sa somewhere kasama ng mga bata, nagliwaliw, huwag niyo pong gayahin. We were walking in the mall. Suddenly, I receive a text message from a friend who's generously supporting us in the church. And he said that his support we will enjoy until June of 2021. Instead of me praising the Lord that we still have 6 months to enjoy that, I asked the Lord immediately, Lord, anong gagawin ko? Lord, bakit ganun, Lord? We're starting, we're doing something good, we're moving. Alam niyo po na we have 17 new small groups reaching out and sharing the gospel, evangelistic groups. Our small groups is at 50. Eksakto pong 50. 49 lang po the other day nung nakita namin si Ate Marcel, hindi pala nabilang yung small group niya. So 50 small group in the church, including the new 17 new ones. Some died, some has to be reorganized. So from kaya parang 10 lang yung nadagdag kasi 30 na tayo eh. 20 pa rin pala. 18, tama. But nonetheless, sabi ko, Lord, kailangan natin ito ng ano eh. Kailangan ng support. Kailangan ng tulong. Bakit ngayon to? And suddenly, the rush of the word of God came sa akin. And simply sinasabi niya sa akin, Raymond, di ba yung preaching mo? All about it. All about the crossroads. Can't you trust me that I was faithful enough to lead you towards this point? Para ho akong binuhusan ng mga lamig na tubig na may isang blocking yelo. Nauntog ako. There are times in our lives that para tayong, ba't hindi gumagana yung clicker ko? Sinabotahin na naman ako. Talaga to si Geraldo. Anyway, in your OBS, you will see it, no? Okay. So, para tayong nasa every season, at the start of the season, ayaw sa akin. Hindi ko ginalaw. Diyan ka na lang. Okay. Down. Down kasi. Kasi naman ako eh. Bata pa ko eh. Down kasi. O di ba minsan nalilimutan niyo po yung mga dapat niyong gawin, di ba? Happy New Year. Akala ko po kasi down na kasi 2021. Up pala. Anyway, many of us like this meme wants 2020 over. Tama ba? You saw this meme ng ano nyo, ng avatar nyo na parang lumayas ka na 2020, ayaw na namin sa inyo. Di ba? We are all dreaming to go back to the better normal that we have. Right? We are dreaming that at one point, we will receive the vaccine and the vaccine will protect us. Para bang we are at war and yung Avengers, di ba? Na sa kanila lang ito matatapos. Malapit na itong matapos yung endgame na. Gustong-gusto na natin siya umalis. Pero pag inisip mo, is 2021 secured? Is 2021 a time that we can say, okay, magiging okay na lahat? We read an article by the Foreign Secretary of Singapore saying that in Southeast Asia, 2021 will be bad, will be worse. Economically, lahat, it will be worse. For us to have vaccine, our government has to loan, and loan a lot. Only, what, 20%, 30% of the population will be vaccinated. We're thankful that may mga companies that will do that. Bumibili sila ng million-million, tapos magdo-donate din sila ng ilang million para magkaroon tayo. Pero think about it, we're 120 million Filipinos. And March pa daw magkakaroon ng vaccine according to DOH. Pag inisip mo, di pa rin, di ba? Parang you are just at that crossroad na ano nga bang mangyayari? Our president said before Christmas na magpa-face-to-face na dun sa mga walang, hindi naman sa Metro Manila kasi hindi pa pwede talaga sa Metro Manila. Pero, just before New Year, binawi niya, sinabi niya, hindi pa pwede. Which is true because we still don't know if there's a surge because of what happened this past 2 weeks. We had Christmas celebration, family reunions. Di natin alam. We still have vague numbers. Kahapon ilan? 1,000 lang. The other day, 1,700. We don't know. We don't know. I have a friend whose work, last day of work last year was December 28. 29. And wala na siyang work after. She was retrenched. So, this psalm that we will talk about is all about these uncertainties in life. Yung tipong nasa crossroads ka, malapit ka na, matapos, pero hindi pa. If you have your Bibles with you, you can open it to Psalms 126. This is a song of ascent. Even, it's called the Psalm of Zion, according to some commentators. Let me give you the background of the psalm before I read it. Many Israelites felt the same way during the captivity. Yung bang ganito, parang hindi lang yung year yung sa kanila. Ang naisip nila, we will be free. Magiging malaya na kami dito from the bandage and of the Babylonians, pwede na kaming lumipat. Bumalik sa Zion. Bumalik sa Jerusalem. Okay? The community used this psalm to lament before the Lord during that time. Siguro mga 538 BC daw. But this psalm is also a prayer for restoration. That's a clue bakit ito okay na okay para sa atin. So, let's read it. Psalms 126. When the Lord restored the fortunes of Zion, we were like those who dreamed. Our mouths are filled with laughter, our tongues with songs of joy. Then it was said amongst the nation, the Lord has done great things for them. The Lord has done great things, and we are filled with joy. Restore our fortunes, Lord, like the streams in Negev. Those who sow with tears will reap with songs of joy. Those who go out weeping, carrying seeds to sow, will return with songs of joy, carrying sheaves with them. May the Lord add blessing as we have read His word. To many of us, looks like this. Right? It looks like hope. Parang, that's how we look at it. It's full of hope. Like these people na, Lord, dinala mo kami dito. Binabalik mo na kami sa Zion. Pero, pagdating nila sa Zion, broken lahat ng walls, right? Siyempre, galing sila sa war, wala pang pagkain, wala pang lahat. Pero, they have trusted God. They have trusted Yahweh that God will help them rebuild. That Yahweh will help them produce more for them. They have that hope. And at the crossroads of life, we always feel something. Aside from hope, right? We feel fear. Takot. Hindi ko alam kung ano mangyayari bukas. Tama? Hindi ko alam mangyayari pagdating ni Kuya Rolly sa January 11. Or makakaalis ba siya? Pabalik ng Qatar after? Or makakapag-aral pa ba ako face-to-face? Would there still be a face-to-face church? We all miss you here. Papasalamat nga po kami that meron na kaming kausap sa loob, hindi na lang camera eh. Nung Marso, camera lang kausap namin. Cellphone camera pa. Diba? We don't know what will happen. Tatawa ako kay Master Hanston, di ba? Sabi niya, 2020 will be a swerte year. Yan, nanalo, naniwala sa swerte, may nalas tuloy. Diba? There's always a question of the future. Will the Lord bless me still? The psalmist show a positive way of looking into the future by asking God's blessings for them. By returning to the rock of their salvation, declaring that today they will rejoice, deciding to say, today is the day I won't worry about tomorrow. I'm giving you my fears and sorrow. Where you lead me, I will follow. I'm trusting what you say. Today is the day. Yun yung sinasabi ng Psalm eh. Lord, bless us. Magdadala kami ng mga seeds sa farm, pero will you bless us? Will you come and we're seeing na babalik kami ng sobra-sobra yung produce namin? That we can provide for the temple, we can provide for our families. That's hope. And I pray that that hope is how you see 2021. Putting, nilalagay po natin yung ating pananampalataya at ang ating, ang lahat ng iniisip natin sa future sa Diyos na may hawak ng lahat. There are three facts that we have or we know, we feel, or mga bagay na, simpleng totoo lang siya. at the crossroad. Every start of the year, every crossroad that you will face, every kung bago kang graduate whatsoever, every new thing in your life, tatlong bagay yung pwede niyong isipin. Una, the uncertainties of the future. We simply don't know what holds in the future. Bukas, hindi natin alam. Mamaya, hindi ko alam. Diba? Mamayang hapon lang, hindi natin alam kung anong gagawin natin. Alam natin kung anong kakainin natin kasi pre-prepare natin yun. Pero, kung anong mangyayari kinabukasan, hindi natin alam. It's so uncertain. Right? The second thing, is that there's always proofs of the past. The faithfulness of God in every way. Right? Simply what Pastor Jero said, he offered his first fruits to the Lord last year, and the Lord just has blessed him na as if walang nawala dun sa budget. In fact, most probably, nadagdagan pa. Right? And I know all of you would have a story like that. You will have a story, a proof of God's presence in your life in the past. Tama? Na hindi lang siya na totoo siyang tapat. Na inihatid ka niya at itinawid ka niya sa kabilang landas. Right? When we think about 2020, diba? We would know, we would have more stories about God. Sino pong nag-enjoy kasama ang pamilya niya for 3 or 4 months together? Diba? Sino rin po yung nagalit sa mga kapatid nila at mga dahil hindi naghuhugas ng pinggan. Hindi nagliligpit ng kama. Diba? Kasi nga, sama-sama eh. Nandun eh. But the joy that it brings, it's a blessing from God. Right? That whatever we go through, anuman po yung pinagdadaanan natin, yung faithfulness ng Diyos, naroroon. And when you look at the past, even the most hardest part of your life, you would see, uy, napagtagumpayan ko yun. Uy, tinawid ako ng Diyos from there. So, the uncertainties of the future is covered by the proofs of the past. Right? That natatabunan yung takot mo kasi you have the same God. Right? Which leads me to my third point. The constants of the present. December 25, we celebrated Christmas. If Christmas is about gifts, the best gift we have received. Right? And what is that? God with us. Emmanuel. Emmanuel has come. I so like our cross. Ewan ko po kung nakikita nyo sa camera, pero I so like this cross and how Ate Kix was able to envision it before habang ginagawa itong hall natin. Ate Dorcas. Diba? Kix kasi tawag ni Uncle Rene. Ate Dorcas. Na I did not imagine that the stage would be like this. You know why I so love the stage and the cross? The cross is not up. Aside from low ceiling tayo, pangit siyang tignan doon. Pero the cross simply represents that He's with us. The greatest gift of all. The constant of the present that we will face. Na kahit na sobra yung uncertainties natin sa future, He is with us. God is with us. Emmanuel is with us. Right? So that every time you see this cross, you have a problem, just pray, Lord, be with me. Carry me through. Because that's His promise. Diba? God is the same. Whether we are facing a difficulty, a very difficult time in our lives, or whether we're enjoying life, He is the same. Yesterday, today, and forever. He's the same God who's sweet in every way. Who knows kung ano yung gusto mo at i-spoil ka, ibibigay yung gusto mo. Hingin mo lang. Di ba? Tama po ba? He knows that. He's loving all the way. Yun yung pinakagusto kong description ngayon, His humor is all the best. It's the best humor in town. Yung tipong matatawa ka na lang kasi nakalimutan mo na ganun yung Diyos mo. Na siya yung bahala sa'yo. Wala kang dapat ikabahala, wala kang dapat iproblemahin. Hindi naman walang dapat problemahin. Diba? Wala kang dapat problemahin ng sobra-sobra. Dahil ang Diyos mo, sobrang mapagmahal, sobrang alam kung anong kailangan mo. We can face the future because He holds it. One of my favorite hymns says, because He lives, I can face tomorrow. That even if we face a dark future, we can trust that the most profound and intimate experience we can have with Him is that point in time at your darkest hour. Rick Warren said, dinagdag ko po ito kagabi kasi nag-man up kami, nakita ko sa libro ni Kuya Jason. Rick Warren said, your most profound and intimate experiences of worship will be likely be in your darkest days when your heart is broken. The uncertainties of the future. Ang pinaka-ayaw natin doon, brokenheartedness eh. Yung masasaktan tayo. Pero if we can put our lives in a loving God, in a God that who can break our hearts gently, break it to me gently. If we can put our trust in that God, we can put our life in that God. To that God. Then, and only then, we can expect the most intimate and the most profound worship we can have. Kasi wala tayong takot. Alam nyo, sinabi ko na to yung one of my preachings, I know, ang pinaka-ayaw ko, sinabi ko to kay Lord, nung alam na namin that my father is about to leave earth, going to His eternal home. Lord, ayoko pong mamili ng casket ng tatay ko. Hindi ko po kaya, Lord. You know what? The Lord did not grant me that prayer request. Did not grant me that prayer request. I chose my father's casket. I chose my mom's casket. Yet, at this point in my life, that's a proof of the past, how faithful God is to me and to our family. That during those times of mourning, yung time mo to worship God, yung time mo to pray, wow, kakaiba. So if you're fearing, kung natatakot ka sa darating na panahon dahil masusugatan ka, masasaktan ka, wag. Kasi dun mo mas makikilala yung Diyos. Dun mo mas makikilala si Lord. That's the theology of suffering. That sometimes this world don't want to hear that eh. Di ba? Tama ba? Ang gusto nyo dodoble. Nasaan si Dodoble? Wala si Dodoble. Di ba? Gusto natin dodoble. Ayaw natin yun. Hindi ayaw natin. Siyempre gusto natin dodoble. Ako nga, ang sagot ko, titriple. Pag nagbigay ako, titriple. Hindi lang doble, di ba? Ganun si Lord eh. Kaya niya kahit quadruple, kahit times 10. Di ba? Bakit doble lang hihingin mo? Pero let's remember that this God would lead you to those difficult times. Hindi para iwanan ka. Yun yung pinaka-importante. Hindi para iwanan ka, kung hindi para ipakilala pa ng husto kung sino siya sa buhay mo. Tama? Amen? So if you're fearing 2021, then Lord, supakit ang makilala. Expect the unexpected. Expect worst. Pero when you expect worst, remember that God is with you. The constant of the present is still constant. God with us. Amen? So, what's my suggestion as we start this year? One, laugh and sing about God's faithfulness. Tawanan mo. Tawa ka lang. Dream, di ba? Pagka nakuha mo yung isang dream mo, di ba tuwang-tuwa ka? Na minsan para kang sira ulo, tumatawa ka. Di ba? Kasi nakuha mo, inabot mo. Sinagot ka nung crush mo, di ba tawa ka ng tawa? Para kang sira ulo. Pero, mapapakanta ka pa, pag in love ka nga, kanta ka ng kanta. Si Jero, kanta ng kanta to eh. In love eh. Pero alam niyo po, meron ako na discovering bagong band. Ang song leader po si Kiko. Sa Grandia, meron silang upbeat praise and worship. Sabi nila, "Hello Araneta!" Pero that's a proof of God's faithfulness. Singing is a proof of God's faithfulness. Amen. So, we laughed, we sing because those are blessings. Right? Don't forget about that. What's your song of victory? Always remember that. Hindi po songs from Victory Church. Ang sinasabi ko, songs of your victories. Ano yon? Remember to sing that. Ako isa mga sa songs ko dyan, Count Your Blessings. Alam niyo po ba yung Count Your Blessings? When upon life's billows you are tempest tossed, when you are discouraged thinking all is lost, count your many blessings, name them one by one, and it will surprise you what the Lord has done. Right? You just simply sing and laugh your way out. Kasi yun naman yung promise ng Psalm eh. Diba? all the nations, our mouths are filled with laughter, our tongues with songs of joy. And all the people would say, ay, bakit siya tumatawa? Bakit siya masaya? And that's the time you can share to them, I have a God who's constant every time. Hindi ako kinakalimutan, mahal na mahal ako. Amen? Sing and laugh about God's faithfulness. Second, let God's love overflow through you. Let the love of God overflow from your heart, from your life. The laughter that you have, the singing, the joy, the rejoicing that you have in life, let it overflow to others. Right? How do you overflow? Work out your salvation. Discipline, you pray, you read God's word. As you work out your physical bodies, especially you're thinking that 2021 you need to lose weight. We need to lose weight. Opo, we need to lose weight. Narinig niyo po akong tama. But you also have to work out your spiritual needs. Right? And that's part of overflowing. Hindi ka mag-overflow kung hindi ka nagpe-pray. Hindi ka mag-overflow kung hindi ka nagbabasa ng Bible. Hindi ka mag-overflow kung hindi ka nag-share ng gospel. Hindi ka mag-overflow kung hindi ka nag-journal. Hindi ka mag-overflow kung hindi nagahari si Kristo sa buhay mo. The Lord can overflow you. He's like that river in Negev. The lowest point on earth. Pero nag-overflow siya. Kaya ng Lord yun eh. Pero you have to be with Him. Jeremiah 9:23 and 24 says, this is what the Lord says. Let not the wise boast of their wisdom or the strong boast of their strength or the rich boast in their riches. But let the one who boast about this, that I have the understanding to know me. That I am the Lord who exercise kindness, justice, righteousness on earth. For in this I delight, declares the Lord. Why is this passage? Yung point na ang pwede lang po nating ipagmalaki. Nakilala natin si Jesus. Nakilala natin ang Panginoon. At we practice what? Kindness, justice, righteousness on the earth. Right? Let all of these things overflow in you. Third, yield to the unchanging God. Yield to Him. Pag sinabi ng yield, suko. Lord, suko ako sa'yo. Two hands up. Right? Hindi yung, Lord, bahala. Bahala ka. Sige ka. Alis ako sa church. Hindi mo ako bilinis. Alis ako sa church. Nanakot ka pa eh. Di ba? Knowing God is knowing this unchangeable God and kaya nating sumuko. Kaya nating sumuko, lalo na alam natin that Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. We yield to this God. Who can give to us what we want, maybe not how we want it. Hindi yung pag-imagine mo, di ba? Parang yung mga batas ni anak nila Jero na nag-imagine sila na makakakuha sila ng gift sa Christmas. Ang Jero po, biniro. Binigyan ng chips, clover. Di iyak sila ng iyak. Diba? Sometimes we're like that eh. Yung humor nga ni Lord at His best, diba? Sometimes, ayaw, parang Lord, ayaw mo akong bigyan nito eh, di ba? Kasi ayaw mo na talagang close lahat eh. Pero, miraculously, He made a way. A different way. Right? That's how Jesus came. That's how sweet God is. Susuko ka lang kay Lord. Huwag kang hindi susuko. Pag hindi ka sumuko, mas mahirap yon. Tama? Tama po ba? Next point is that, so what did I say? Laugh? Sing? Di ba? Sing to this God? Ano pa? Let God's love overflow through you. The third one, yield to this unchanging God. And the fourth one is that you move on with the mighty God. Move on. Move on with this year, with this mighty God. Don't let this mighty God mawala sa tabi mo. Rather, you move on with Him. Those who go out weeping, carrying seeds to sow, umiiyak sila, dala-dala nila yung mga buto, will return with songs of joy, carrying sheaves with them. That as we share the gospel, we move on with this mighty God. I am reminded that this is our fifth year. And we have a goal, 300 at 5. 300 members at 5 years. We're down to what? 6-7 months? The good news is that we're at 220 the last count. Plus minus, we don't know. 80 more. Kaya po ba natin? Kaya po ba natin? I believe so. We can because we have a mighty God. We walk and we move with this mighty God. We walk with the Spirit. We don't walk alone. Di ba? We walk with this big God, with this mighty God. I'm reminded of the Sunday school song that we used to sing. My God is so big, so strong, and so mighty. There's nothing our God cannot do. Amen? We trust in this God who's big, strong, and mighty, that in whatever would happen, God's blessings will come. And we can say, today is the day that I will rejoice. Today is the day na sasabihin ko, Lord, I would leave you my fears and my sorrows. Diba? That today we can say, Lord, ikaw ang bahala. Amen. Let me end you with one song that we were able to produce during the pandemic. And this song simply would say, Itatawid ka sa landas. It still is our song. Na ang Panginoong Jesus ang patuloy na magtatawid sa atin sa landas ng buhay. I want us to use this as our point of reflection as we prepare our hearts in commemorating His death and His resurrection. At the same time, how we will face tomorrow. Look at the past. Be reminded that God is constant, that He will lead us through. Ready na po ba? Sige po, ipasok na natin.
Bawat dahon ng aklat ng buhay, bakas ang luha na tumatangay. Inaanod ang pag-asa, unti-unting nawawala. Haligin ng munting daigdig ko, insay ng lalamig na rin ang araw. Ihip ng hangin ay giniginaw. Nalulumo, nalulumbay, hanap ay isang gabay. Sa piling mo ay hindi mabibigo. Kahit magunaw man ang daigdig, lisanin man ang imig at mundong nanlalamig. Kahit na mayo sa daan, magkabilay bangin, ikaw pa rin, O Diyos, ikaw pa rin. Pag-ibig mo'y hindi magwawakas, linga mo, O Diyos, ang siyang magbibigay lakas. Sa anumang panganib, tinintuan ang iyong pagliligtas. Panatag na tiyak, itatawin mo sa sa tadhana'y di nais ang buhi. Bawang sagabal ang sinasabi. Ikaw ang siyang tatawagan. Sarot ko'y aapawan ng pag-asang kailan may dulot mo.
Kahit magunaw man ang daigdig, lisanin man ng init ang mundong nanlalamig, ikaw pa rin, O Diyos, ikaw pa rin. Nawa po yung katotohanan ng kanta na yun ay patuloy na mag-ingay sa inyong mga puso, sa inyong isipan. Na siya na may likha ng langit at lupa, ang Diyos na mapagmahal, ang siyang magtatawid sa atin sa landas ng buhay. Ngayong linggo pong ito, muli po nating aalalahanin ang ginawa ng Panginoong Hesus sa krus ng Kalbaryo. Ang tinapay, nagsisimbolo ng kanyang katawan na naghirap para sa atin. Ang saro, na nagsisimbolo ng dugo niya na naglilinis sa ating mga kasalanan. Ngayong unang linggo ng taong ito, alalahanin po natin ang pagmamahal ng Diyos. Hinihiling po namin yung mga tatay na nasa bahay to just ready to distribute the elements to your family. If you're alone and you have the elements with you, just wait for us. If kung di ka naka-prepare, just be with us as we do this. And join us spiritually as one body to declare that Jesus Christ is our Savior, Sanctifier, Healer, and our coming King. Naanyayahan ko po si Pastor Jero at si Pastor Gerard to come and distribute the elements. Before that, we will pray. Lord, may your blessings be upon these elements. May the truths that it represents ring in our hearts and in our minds as we do this morning and in the days to come. We give you praise in Jesus' name. Amen.
Pagkapalad ko sa piling mo, kahit na ako'y hindi tapat.
Check. At this point, I want you to just reflect. Ano po ba yung fears nyo? Ano po ba yung mga kinakatakot nyo sa darating na taon, sa mga darating na araw? Why not lay it down to this loving God, this God who cares for us and who's loving all the time? Come to Him. Just tell Him, Lord, takot ako sa darating na panahon. Lord, I don't know what's there. Surrender it to this God who loves you so much. Lord, I stand before your presence this morning. I stand for in behalf of your people here in Impact Church, bringing everything, Father, that brings fears in their lives. Lord, dala ko po, Lord, yung takot nila sa pagharap nila sa panibagong taon. Nilalagak po namin lahat ito sa iyong banal na trono sapagkat alam namin, Lord, you have said in your word, cast all your cares on me for I care for you. So Lord, we cast everything to your hands and in your throne. And Jesus said to us that come to me, all of you who are weary and heavily laden, and I will give you rest. And my yoke is easy. So Lord, we trust in these words as we remember your death, your suffering, your death, your resurrection. We lay all of these cares to you, Lord, and carry and let dalhin mo po ito, Panginoon, with us. And will you, O God, the God of Jacob, Abraham, Isaac, embrace my brother and my sister. Lift their burdens up. Remind them of how good you are. Let's all rise. On the night Jesus was betrayed, he took the bread. After giving thanks, he broke it and said, "This is my body broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Let's all partake. Lord Jesus, we thank you for how you have suffered on the cross. Before, during, how you endured that suffering so that we can feel your love. In the same manner, the Lord Jesus Christ that night took the cup. After giving thanks to the Father, he said, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this in remembrance of me." Let's all partake. Lord, we thank you that your blood flow freely on the cross of Calvary. And it still flows for us, Lord God. We thank you for the forgiveness of sins. We thank you for the love that this blood brings. We thank you for the strength that it provides us. Lord, you also said that whenever we drink the cup and eat the bread, we proclaim your death, your resurrection. More importantly, Father, you said that you will come again. Lord, give us strength to share the gospel to others. Lord, give us that drive, that passion, Lord, for the lost. That we are not just simply taking this as a ceremony, Lord God, but it would titimo po sa aming puso at sa aming isipan na patuloy naming iproklama na ikaw ay darating muli para sa mga naniwala sa iyo. And that your love covers everyone, so we need to share the gospel to everyone. Lord, we thank you for your word. We thank you for this acted sermon. We thank you for simply who you are. We thank you for the joy that you bring in our lives. We thank you for the strength that you continue to provide. We praise you, Father, for who you are. And today, Lord, we say, this is the day that you have made. This is the day we will rejoice. This is the day we will say, Lord, I won't worry about tomorrow. I will cast my fears and sorrows before you. Wherever you will lead, Lord God, I will follow. We will follow. We're trusting what you say that today is the day. My brothers and sisters receives the blessings from God. Now to Him who's able to do immeasurably more than you can ask or imagine, according to the power that is work in us, to Him be the glory in the church, in Jesus Christ, throughout all generations. Amen and amen.
I live for you.
All my days I live.